Hi there, it's Marilda. Do you know that the first god ever in our history was female? Yes, she was a goddess. So, welcome to the Princess Left the Tower. I am Marilda, and make sure you grab a coffee because I'm going to take you through the history to learn a bit more about matriarchal societies, both in ancient time, our remote past, and even today, because yes, even today, 2021, there are matriarchal communities around the world, and I'm so excited about that, and I guess you too if you are listening to this. So let's dig in. During the Paleolithic times, I promise it's not going to be boring, okay, but it's important for you to know that the first representation of human beings were all female. And I'm going to show you some picture in a while, but you might know what I'm talking about, these huge, big statues, or even a small pendant, but huge women, like big, big breasts. All those symbolize prosperity, nourishment. So it is interesting to notice that the very first expression, art expressions of our ancestors were women, actually. So yes, there was at the beginning of all these goddesses. The anthropologists called them Venuses. Now look at this. This is a small pendant found in a cave in Germany and dates back 35,000 years. This is the first representation of human beings. And as you see, this one has big breasts, big buttocks, and a huge vagina. Can you see it? I'm not going to circle it in red, so make sure you find it yourself. So, have you seen it? Right. Now let's jump to Neolithic times. At those times, there were these amazing megalithic civilizations. And again, they were all matriarchal. There are signs, here in Malta, for instance, where I live now, there are these megalithic, gigantic settlements. And in those sites, the scientists have found statues of women. Look at them, they are so beautiful. This one or this one, and even these, they call the twins. But I like to think there are two friends hanging in a bar, sipping cocktails, right? And this is my favorite one. This is the sleeping lady. Look how beautiful she is. She's big. She's welcoming, like her body is welcoming. She relaxes and she is so peaceful. Peaceful. All these megalithic settlements around the world, and you can find them not only here in Bolton, but also in Great Britain, Spain, France, and Central Europe. All these megalithic settlements don't have walls, don't have fortifications around them. That means that war was unknown. And to know why, go check my first video of this serial where I explain why. So peaceful societies, matriarchal and peaceful societies. There is one historian that I really like because he was obsessed with matriarchy. His name is Johann Jacob Bachofen. I'm terrible with names, so I'm going to write it now so you can check it. He assumed and demonstrated that at the beginning of our history, in our remote past, there were matriarchal societies. And they were all living in peace and collaborating in order to nourish the community and benefits, you know, the community. And at a certain point, something happened. So from matriarchy, we started with the patriarchy, what's in between. You may be familiar with some Greek myth, for instance, the story of Medea or the Amazons. They all talk about women fighting against men, and many scientists think that these are mere representations of psychological problems with the opposite sex. But Bachofen thinks that those are not representation of psychological problems, but they are memories of a real social conflict that took place long time ago. So imagine there were these matriarchal societies living in peace, and at a certain point something happened. Men wanted to take over. They decided to take the power. So they started to fight. There were huge, dramatic social conflicts, and then the patriarchy won, and then it started. But when exactly men managed to win? When they realized that the true power, the things that was at the beginning of everything, was the spiritual power, the spirituality, and women were in charge of spirituality. In those matriarchal societies, women were the ones who were caring for the fire. And I will talk about that in another video. The relationship between woman and fire is very, very ancient. It's very interesting. So men realized that spiritual power was the thing that would, you know, run a society. They stole it. They deprived women of that power, and they started to be gods, right? So we know gods. So the thing that was important was this spiritual powers, right? But patriarchy couldn't win everywhere in the world. There are still places here and there where matriarchal societies survived. And it's amazing. But yes, there are. For instance, look at this picture. We have the Mushuo of Yunnan region in China, community led by women. Or the Bemba from Central Africa. Look at them. They are so beautiful. And Kuna from Panama. And these are Trobriandese women from Melanesia. They are all beautiful. They are all, you know, looking so powerful. And especially these ones, these are the Minangkabau of Sumatra. And in this case, we are talking about 4 million people still living according this value of, you know, nourishment, of sharing, of giving benefits for all the members of your community. The core value of the matriarchal societies in the past and in the present is life. Not power, money, rule, blah, blah, control. No, life, you know? So how can we retrieve that inner power? How can you retrieve that inner power? Because think about it, inside every human there is this fire, this voice, something which is powerful but has been forgotten and always misunderstood, maybe, no, during the centuries. Now I'm going to read a short text for you, which is beautiful, it's amazing, and it really explains what I'm trying to say here. So here it goes. A woman's most powerful weapon is the inner energy that protects her and everyone she loves. It is for the reason that you will have to learn to enter your inner world. Only when you discover your true essence, you can use all your inner energy. You are strong and endowed with a lot of energy, which is why you belong to the group of women who can move the world. And yet, you have a limit. You don't know yourself yet, and as a result, you don't accept yourself. It's beautiful, isn't it? This is from Mamani, who wrote La Profezia della Curandera, amazing book. As you see, the power of women is this huge ability to protect life, to give nourishment, and to maintain harmony and balance between humankind and nature. This is a powerful, powerful weapon that we have. This is inside us, but that we lost it along the way. But there is a way to recover it. And in the next video, it will be published on Sunday, so make sure you stay tuned. I will share 7 tips on how to recover this wonderful power that we have and how to use it not only for our benefits, but also for the benefits of our society. So make sure you watch the second video to discover how you can do that. So thank you so much for watching this video. I'll be back soon. Ciao.